So the way that wildfires start are basically a human ignitions and then natural ignitions. Humans being lighting the fire on purpose, or they can do it by accident, throwing a cigarette butt out, or by leaving a campfire that still has hot coals in it. And then naturally, the most common natural form of ignition is lightning. And then we have just biomass igniting spontaneously, which is not very frequent, but it can happen. Land managers use fire to prevent wildfires, which seems kind of contradictory, but what they're doing is they're burning off the excess fuel on the landscape. When a wildfire is coming up, wind is pushing it, it's moving fast, and then it comes up on an area where we had a prescribed fire within the past year, maybe 2 years, it comes up on that area, and all of a sudden the fuel is not there, and it just dies down. There's good fires and there's bad fires. A wildfire being bad because they can cause a lot of unwanted damage. Control fires being good because they remove hazardous fuels and have other ecological benefits associated with them. Well, obviously fires have a major effect on the environment, depending upon the intensity of the fire. It burns biomass, burns up fuels that are found on the ground or in the forest. A lot of smoke comes off of fire. So if you think about it, when fires are burning, the chemical reaction is pretty much just the opposite of photosynthesis. So instead of collecting the sun's energy and putting it into making biomass, it's combining the fuels with oxygen and releasing the sun's energy out into the environment, and it generates a lot of smoke. There's some very positive effects on it also. So many plants and some ecosystems and even animals and even insects, they have adapted to living with fire. And they, in several cases, they'll only regenerate or maintain themselves if there's a fire is coming into the ecosystem. So the only thing we really have control over is the fuel. People have been using fire to reduce the vegetation for eons. So they have what we call the fire triangle, is the three elements necessary for fire. If you take away any side of the triangle, you can't have fire. So that's, fuel is one of the sides of the triangle. The other one is oxygen, and the third one is heat. Removing the fuel removes the possibility of fire. I've been thinking a lot about the fires in California, and I look at the pictures of it, of what's going on, and what I see, a lot of times, I see a lot of remnants of vegetation. And when things get dry, they burn, and if the vegetation is close to the house, it's just providing fuels for the fires to move through and catch the houses. Houses are a form of fuel also. So there's a whole program that the Forest Service across the country put on. It's called Firewise Communities. And what that is it's getting a community together to organize, to make their homes more fireproof. And by fireproof, I mean the fire can't get up to their house. The wildfire can't get to a house that has been gone through the Firewise community process. The wildfires are getting more intense within the United States for several factors. Probably the biggest of these factors are drought conditions. The more drought you have over a longer time period, the lesser the moisture content, the more the fires are going to ignite. North Carolina has a higher percent of the land than any other state, which is in the wildland urban interface. So it's categorized as people living in the forest. But those houses, unless you start doing fuel removal around the houses, those houses are just big piles of fuel ready to burn. Given the right conditions, wildfires are very much possible in North Carolina. And actually, we have a lot of wildfires every year.